So when you will verify this hash code inside your computer that the file you are getting is genuine or not, you must have the same hash code as same that what I have provided on the article. So the source and the Hey, hello YouTube, I'm Karan from India, and in this video I'm going to talk about a little problem we all are facing while using and distributing the batch plugins, because they are an executable files and we don't know the executable is coming from a genuine resource or not. So, and antivirus also considered them as a virus in most of the cases without any genuine reason. So we are quite afraid of using those plugins and we don't know about how to check about their genuinity. So here I'm coming up with the solution. So the problem arises when I came across this problem when we just created the amazing batch store application for our batch blog, thebatteam.org, and when we have posted about it, and the idea of the batch store is from Papertronics and the other things related to the batch store. So here we have get a false claim, or we don't know about the claim. So in under the comments you will see that Papertronics, the Lego Store Pro, and Papertronics have some issues, that Lego is saying that Papertronics have stolen his idea, and he has, but I don't know about what happened. So but the Lego has claimed a false accuse of the batch store having 11 viruses in it. And first of all, I want to clarify that the virus total do not tell how many viruses are there in the file. It just tell that how many antivirus had detected this file as a virus. So here is the original scan of the batch store that we have created. It is detected by two antiviruses. It does not have two viruses. It is detected by two antiviruses out of 61. And the file Lego has provided has detected by 11 antiviruses out of 61. So you will see that both have 1 month time of uploading. So when we have uploaded the file, he has also uploaded some other file. But you can detect that in the Lego's file, when you will go into the file details, you will find that there is a very little detail. And when you will go into the batch store of hash this, we'll talk about these hashtags, hash codes, and you will go into the file details, you will see that copyright is from, and we have taken the copyrights and the batch store by KVC, the product name, the file version, and the description of the file is all things are there. But in the Lego's file, nothing is there. So, and the main thing, the main difference of between these files is that the file type and file size, where is the file size, let me find the file size here, and let me additional information, and you will see that the file size of the Lego's file is 91.8 KBs in size, while in our case it is about 17 MBs. So that's a quite proof that Lego is claiming a false allegations on the batchstore.exe file. They just named a file batchstore.exe and scan it over the virus total, and when it is detected by 11 antiviruses, they have claimed that it has 11 viruses. So when we have talked about, when we explained the difference between these two files, and then because they do not understand English that much easily, so they just got angry and told that are you so low and that threaten me and I will delete all your videos and blah blah blah. So these are all childish thing, but we don't know about why they did so. So this misunderstanding and the wrong allegations. So I have found a good solution for this problem, as in from the next articles we will provide a hash code, 256 SHA hash code. Like you will see here a SHA 256 hash code of this much length related to the original bash store, and you can simply verify these things and you will see the bashstore.exe by the Lego has different hash code. So every file, every executable file or every other file you will scan through the SHA 256 algorithm will give a different hash code. If you will change this bashstore.exe a little bit and scan again through the SHA 256 algorithm, it will change the hash code of the file. So these things verify the genuinity of the file from the source. Like if I will provide the bashstore.exe and I have the hash code this, then the file you are getting should also be have the same hash code. For verifying this, I have created a simple plugin and you can use this to verify the hash codes. Let me find this, and here is the I have created a folder genuinity test. Here you can see two files, like in the case of Lego. So I have created a simple scenario here. So what I have done is I have created a simple plugin, named it as bat.exe, and then I have created a batch file and called this plugin from this batch file and named the output. Let me delete this now, and named the output bashstore number.exe. So it is difficult to find which one is the original one, but as you can see here that it is a 162 KB of file and this one is of 17 MB of file. So original bashstore is this one, but let's say we can't say which one is the original one. So here is the two SHA 256 sum algorithm. So what we need to do is we need to hold shift key, right click, open the command window here, and let me close that. Okay, and as you can see here the CMD window is here, so let me snap it to the right and let me make it a little wider. So call the SHA 256 sum algorithm and just write the name of the file. So the name, you can change, rename the file whatever you want. The SHA 256 hash code will be remain same for that executable, because it does not depend on the name, it depends on the data structure and inside byte arrangement of the file. So when we will press, you will press enter, it will take some time depending on the size of the file and it will generate a hash code. So as you can notice that bashstore1.exe has this hash code, and now do the same thing for the bashstore2.exe. So let me press enter and you will see another hash code for this file, because both the files are different, so you will see different hash codes. And now when you will scan this, and the one thing to verify this file, if I will provide you with this hash code in the article, so when you will verify this hash code inside your computer that the file you are getting is genuine or not, you must have the same hash code as same that what I have provided on the article. So the source and the destination hash code should match. So this hash code should be there in the virus total algorithm too, because we know that, let me show you again. So we know that 17 MBs of original bashstore is this one, so the number 2. So number 2 has the hash code of OE84525C, and you will see that the original hash code is OE84525C and so on up to 5E8F. So last one is 5E8F. So the hash code remains same no matter how much you have renamed the file. If you will change a little bit of file, the hash code will change. So it confirms the genuinity. And as you will see, the hash code of the file by Lego is this much, and it's totally different. So we can simply say that file is a totally different file. So I have created this plugin SHA256sum.bat. It is quite easy and it uses PowerShell for generating the hash codes. So simply I will upgrade the plugin and add the help menu, standard help menu, and many other things related to a plugin in this one and upload it to the TheBATeam.org. So you can also test this out and confirm the genuinity of the source and that of the final destination, that is your computer. So you, when you will get a file, just pass it through this plugin and confirm the hash code with that article, and you will see that no one can now make fool of you and confirm and say that this is a virus. So that's all for now, and thanks for watching. I hope I have solved this problem, and if you feel anything related to the problem and find that another solution is better than this, so you are welcome in the comment field. Please feel free to subscribe. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.